This is how to get GABA from your food. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmeetails, just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about getting GABA from food. In the last 2 weeks, I've done some episodes on GABA and its use in doses of 100 to 800 milligrams acutely dosed to produce effects like less anxiety, less of a tanking of your immune system when you face stress, when you face your fears under high stress situations, and making better, faster decisions under pressure. In the last episode, I talked about why some people get adverse reactions to GABA that are countered by carbohydrate. Well, if you get your GABA from food, don't worry, you'll be getting it with carbohydrate simply because of the types of foods that it's found in. In the food supply, there are some foods that are quite high in GABA naturally, but mostly it's being produced through fermentation, either lacto-fermentation like you get in sauerkraut or kimchi or yogurt or kefir, or yeast fermentation like you get in bread or beer. So in terms of foods that just have their own GABA in them, wheat germ clocks in quite high at 160 milligrams per 100 grams. Barley bran has 95 milligrams per 100 grams of food. Black soybeans are high in GABA. Black soybean milk for 100 milliliters has 542 milligrams of GABA. Red mustard leaf, if you get 100 grams, you get 178 milligrams of GABA. Adzuki beans, if you get 100 grams, you get 201 milligrams of GABA. White tea is 50 milligrams of GABA for 100 milliliters of tea. So double it up and you get that 100 milligram GABA dose. Potatoes vary and you can get anywhere from 16 to 61 milligrams of GABA from potatoes. So if you have, so some potatoes are fairly high in GABA, where if you double up on them, you get up to that 100 milligram dose of GABA. Now, the issue with fermentation is that it's so strain dependent that if you're trying to get a reliable amount of GABA from fermented foods, really you must use fermented foods that have a verified strain that produces GABA, where the amount of GABA produced is verified. So there are products out there that are fermented, or maybe they're not even fermented, maybe it's germinated rice, where you might get a listed GABA content. And if you get a GABA content listed on the table, then as long as there's nothing untrustworthy about that company, you can probably trust that at least that's the average value in that food. But if you're just relying on fermentation, you're likely to be a little bit disappointed, or your brain's likely to be a little bit disappointed, because if you're looking at something like fermented milk, it is, or cheese, it is so different depending on the specific strains used. But if you're consuming a lot of fermented foods and you find that these foods have effects on you that feel like a GABA effect, like less anxiety, for example, or any of the effects that I talked about in the beginning, like better, faster decision under pressure, or better ability to face your fears without really tanking your immunity from a stress response, then it at least is plausible that those foods are giving you some extra GABA benefit, and that continuing to consume those foods might continue to provide you that benefit.
This episode is brought to you by Ancestral Supplements Living Collagen. Our Native American ancestors believed that eating the organs from a healthy animal would support the health of the corresponding organ of the individual. Ancestral Supplements has a nose-to-tail product line of grass-fed liver, organs, living collagen, bone marrow, and more, all in the convenience of a capsule. For more information or to buy any of their products, go to ancestralsupplements.com. This episode is brought to you by Ample. Ample is a meal in a bottle that takes a total of 2 minutes to prepare, consume, and clean up. It provides a balance of fat, protein, and carbs, plus all the vitamins and minerals you need in a single meal, all from a blend of natural ingredients. It's available in original, vegan, and keto versions, portioned as either 400 or 600 calories per meal. I'm an advisor to Ample, and I use it to save time when I'm working on major projects on a tight schedule. It keeps my brain going while I power through the day, never letting food prep get in the way of my productivity. head to amplemeal.com and enter the promo code CHRIS15 at checkout for a 15% discount off your first order.
The audio of this episode was enhanced and post-processed by Bob Davodian of Torian Mixing. You can find more of his work at torianonlinemixing.com. For ad-free versions of these episodes with transcripts that you can read and getting early access to the episodes often weeks or maybe even months ahead of time, you can sign up for the CMJ Masterpass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code LITE10 to get 10% lifetime discount.
All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.